Swoopes in the place to be. Clyde Drexler's in the place to be. I chunk up the deuce for the south and the north. Boys talking down and boys wanna hate. I chunk up the deuce for the south and the north. Boys talking down, don't make me pull out the chop. I chunk up the deuce for the south and the north. Boys talking down, I leave them on the streets dead. I chunk up the deuce for the south and the north. Boys talking down, I got them diamonds in my mouth. Houston Tex got the streets burning. Papa still with them foes turning. Rookie boys, they still learning. Losing cash, I'm still earning. Get my bread while I shake the Fed. Keep them dimes in and out my bed. Jump in the drop to convert the top and let them buy on candy red. Leather seats with that wood hot. They don't know what my hood buy. Trying to take the young gun spot. I'm platinum bound and I'm still hot.
From the Wortham Center, welcome to the 2022 Houston Sports Awards, presented by Insperity. Please welcome your host for this evening, award-winning journalist, producer, and director, Hannah Storm.
Houston tonight, where it all began for me at 97 Rock. Y'all remember that, right? Channel 26 with the Astros and the Rockets, and then my first big break in TV, home sports entertainment with the great Bill Worrell. Yeah. Can't wait to see him tonight, and making it extra special is my history with so many of the folks here tonight, including icons. I mean, Carl Lewis is here. George Foreman is in the house. How about this? A guy I've known since I was 4 years old, Dr. J, is here gracing us with his presence. So cool. I had such a great time locally covering the Oilers with Warren Moon at NBC, Clyde the Glide, Mario Ellie, the Championship Rockets. I saw Rudy T, Heart of a Champion. Shout out to Rudy T tonight. He's here. And then becoming the first ever WNBA play-by-play announcer as a new mom with another new mom, Sheryl Swoopes, leading the way to 4 titles with the Houston Comets. And the great Cynthia Cooper is here today as well. You know, I even directed a film about Sheryl Swoopes, and very creatively it was called Swoopes, and it did very well. Big shout out tonight to the legend, one of the finest writers in all of the land. Give it up for John McClane, the general. Yes. He set the standard 47 years with the Houston Chronicle. That is a record in and of itself. Yes. And also, my good pal from the music world, Toby Keith, who actually sang to me on the air during my last day at CBS. It is like old home week. We have Kevin Eschenfelder. He's got the great job. He is out there working the crowd tonight. We're going to get to Kevin in just a moment. But first, we are going to celebrate all that happened in sports in 2021. Take a look.
The Houston Rockets select Jalen Green from Merced, California, and the NBA G League Ignite.
Green comes down the baseline.
For the first time in 37 years, the Cougars are going to the Final Four.
The school is hitting on all cylinders, and this was the next step that had to be made. And for Houston now to have a chance to compete on a level playing field with the biggest names in college athletics, that's where, I'm going to say it, we belong.
That way, he's in trouble. Dumps it off for the touchdown, avoids the sack, and throws to McCaskill.
This is what you wanted, Brian, and that's why you wanted it. Dicky Dicky Lottie, the Server Express.
Kid is our poster child. He embodies everything that we could have hoped for with this event. So congratulations, Kit, for winning the Hart Award.
Jason Castro, the Astros' final hope here in the top of the ninth. And that's lifted in the short right center for a base hit.
He got a miss, throw to second. Machete! He did it! Double play! Maldonado!
Houston Astros are headed to the World Series as the Astros win, shutting out the Red Sox 5-0 and take the American League Championship Series.
We did this for the H-Town, and I got the greatest guys in the world. Thank you, guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
now to present the McDonald's Moment of the Year. Please welcome to the stage former Houston Texan and McDonald's owner-operator, Steve McKinney. And from ABC 13, Adam Winkler.
You know, with any great moment, you remember where you were at when you saw that moment. Well, tonight, three of the four moments, I can guarantee that all of you remember what you were doing, where you were when you saw it. But one nominee, there's a good chance none of you saw it. However, it was seen worldwide by over 240 million people.
Wait, tell me it's Bill Worrell doing the savage dance on TikTok.
As much as I wish that was the case, just so we could see it. Bill, I'll have to check that out later. No, this was actually here in Houston, and it revolves around table tennis. It was the 50th anniversary of the ping pong diplomacy, and U.S. and China came together for the first time ever and made history. So, with that, let's take a look at our nominees for Moment of the Year.
The Houston Astros shut out the Boston Red Sox in Game 6 of the ALCS to advance to the World Series for the third time in 5 years. The Houston Cougars advancing to the Final Four for the first time in 37 years. Carlos Correa's go-ahead home run in Game 1 of the ALCS. The United States and China team up for the first time in history in mixed doubles to medal at the World Table Tennis Championship.
All right, four worthy honorees, but only one winner. And the winner of Moment of the Year is the Houston Cougars advancing to the Final Four.
Go Cougs. By default, I'll accept this. You know, a basketball season is a journey to an end. You know, a lot of people focus on destinations, but the journey of starting a season, October, November, December, January, all the way through the Final Four, especially a pandemic here, is something that we'll never forget. Thank you guys very much for this honor. We appreciate it. Go Cougs.
In 2021, the Houston Independent School District created the HISD Athlete Hall of Honor. They got together with Energy Ogre, and 16 individuals were honored as the inaugural class. And tonight, four of them are here to present the Energy Ogre College Athlete of the Year. Please welcome to the stage Carlette Guidry Fauquay, Delvin Williams, Quentin Smith, and Vince Young.
We are so honored to be part of the inaugural class and to be here tonight presenting the College Athlete of the Year Award.
Regardless of whether we are currently living in Houston or somewhere else, I can speak for all of us when I say Houston Independent School District holds a special place in all of our hearts.
Thank you to Energy Org. Thank you to HISD. And now, here are the nominees.
Quentin Grimes, University of Houston basketball. Dejon Giroux, University of Houston basketball. Marcus Jones, University of Houston football. Nicole Mendez, Oklahoma University softball, Olympian, and Houston native.
And the winner is...
Quentin Grimes.
Quentin Grimes.
First off, I want to thank my coaches, teammates. I wouldn't be able to get this award without them. The University of Houston, so just thank you to everybody, really. Thank you.
I have been around the NFL for many, many years. And when I think of the words motivated, humbled, resilient, and purposeful, there's one particular player that stands out, and that is Justin Reed. Justin Reed has made an impact in this Houston community, and I would like to recognize Mr. and Mrs. Reed for raising a remarkable young man. I know that when you bring out the greatness in individuals, greatness will always follow them. And that's so true for Justin Reed. We're so excited to see this new chapter in Justin Reed's career as he goes to Kansas City. But I'm so honored this evening to present the 2022 Sportsmanship Award to my good friend, Justin Reed.
If anybody knows J.J. Moses, you know that he is the big dog, man. That's my guy. He's been my best friend since I've come to Houston, man. So he truly has a special place in my heart. There's so many people for me to thank here tonight. I see so many friendly faces out in the audience. You know, I have my family here. My parents really set the foundation for me to be the type of man that I am today. Give a round of applause for them. And it really means so much to me because they instill values in me. To always give back and give a helping hand whenever the opportunity to do so. You know, so what's always been helpful to me is I know that when I was growing up, I've always had help. So for me pushing that forward, I've always wanted to help the next generation. So that's why I love working with kids. And I'm very excited to announce the launch of J. Reed Indeed, my foundation, which will still be active here in Houston, as well as in Baton Rouge, as in Kansas City now. So thank you to Houston Sports Authority. Thank you to all my friends and family that's here in the audience. I love all of you guys. This is not the end of Justin Reed in Houston. I will still be around, so thanks again. Appreciate you guys.
Yep. And now, for the well-deserved Lifetime Achievement recipient, I am so happy to be just a small part tonight of Bill Worrell's special night. Bill, among many other personal accomplishments, has had such an impact on others through his generosity, his support, and his belief. Bill gave me my start in television. I desperately wanted to become a sportscaster after graduating from Notre Dame. And time again, I was rejected with words like, our audience won't accept a woman, my sports director doesn't want to work with a woman, and I'll hire a woman over my own dead body. Well, not Bill Worrell. I'm literally gonna cry saying this. He not only welcomed me to home sports entertainment with open arms, he generously shared airtime with me and helped me understand how to write and how to deliver the weekly sports calendar, which was my first big assignment. He offered me constant guidance and kindness when I moved on to work on Astros and Rockets coverage. And every time I looked into his famously gorgeous eyes, and everybody knows what I'm talking about, what did I see there? I saw friendship, and I saw a little twinkle that always reminded me to have fun. A video cannot begin to tell the story, but here it is, a man with a heart as big as his native Texas, Bill Worrell.
What is lifetime achievement? How does someone gain this title? Lifetime achievement is the legacy you leave even after you're out of the game. It's when someone dedicates their entire life to something and is able to do great things through it. It's something remarkable. Years of success. Doing something bigger than yourself. It's about what you do when nobody's watching. What you're willing to do when nobody else is. By taking chances. Breaking barriers. Going where nobody else has gone. Seizing opportunity. Turning away from what's comfortable to pursue something unknown. By being the best, being thrown into the fire, and coming out on top. Lifetime achievement is the legacy you leave, even after you're out of the game. Bill Worrell.
Born in 1947 in Houston, Texas, he attended Lamar High School in a time where segregation was prevalent. His father was a dentist, and Bill's plan after graduating high school in 1962 was to attend the University of Houston, studying medicine to follow in his footsteps. When he got to U of H, he started working with the radio station on campus, covering both football and baseball. It was in this season where Bill realized he had a talent for public speaking and decided to change his major to communications and broadcasting.
We're winding up a four-game road trip, and you can watch Moses Malone lead the Rockets versus the Utah Jazz.
In 1970, Bill got his start working at KPRC Radio, where he learned how to write stories, ad-lib, and do stand-up reporting.
The Rockets desperately in need of a win. I'm Bill Worrell, along with John Egan. We'll be back.
On the weekends, Bill worked both the radio side and the TV side of the station, until eventually he went on to land his first on-air gig. In 1974, he was put in a position to cover Super Bowl VIII in Houston. Afterwards, the same man who advised him to stay in news as long as he possibly could later said those six career-changing words, "I need you to do sports."
It's another shot. The Rockets are unbelievable. Puts up the jam.
Bill became the sports director and brought in Anita Martini, who became the first female sports reporter in Houston and one of the first female reporters ever to go into the men's locker room. The unfamiliar never deterred Bill from his work. He always did it with the same passion and energy, giving full support to every colleague. Bill left KPRC in 1980 and started doing play-by-play for the Houston Rockets. In 1982, Bill took a leap of faith and helped launch the regional sports network, HSE. At the time, nobody believed that a regional sports network could make it, except for the few who decided to take that chance. As the lead anchor for the network, Bill also moved into the booth with the Houston Astros, alongside Gene Elston and Milo Hamilton.
Elijah Wan, runner out, Chambers with a slam! Here's Drexler on the run.
Bill developed in his career for 50 years, filling young athletes with wisdom and sharing in some of their most memorable experiences. He knew these players, watched and studied their every move. And before Hakeem Olajuwon became who we know today, it was Bill who saw his potential and knew that he was going to be a star. It was also Bill who had a hand in coining the infamous term, the dream shake.
The clerk turns inside. Oh, the dream shake! Oh!
We always think about the people out in front of the camera, the ones being interviewed and talked about. But what about the person on the other side, making the calls, commenting on the plays, and making them known? Bill Worrell gave support day in and day out to help others be the topic of conversation, to give others the accolades for their achievements, and humbly take his place, declaring everyone else's success rather than his own. Well, Bill, your time has come. You've given nearly five decades to help build up the world of sports in Houston, and you've achieved great and wondrous things. 2011's Lone Star Emmy Award for Best Play-by-Play Announcer in the state of Texas. 2013's Best Play-by-Play Announcer by the Houston Press. Admitted into the University of Houston's Athletics Hall of Fame. 20 seasons covering the Houston Astros. 40 years being the voice of the Houston Rockets. 6 times the United Press International Best Broadcaster. And now, the 2022 Houston Sports Awards recipient of the Lifetime Achievement Award, Bill Worrell.
Well, that's about it from here. This is Bill Worrell saying so long, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Naismith Basketball Hall of Famer, Calvin Murphy.
My opinion. Bill, you're very lucky, Bill. They only gave me 2 minutes out of a lifetime that we had together to talk about you. But before I start, Bill, I got a message from my mother. She said, congratulations. You remember when you met my mother? And she said, he's not bad looking for a white guy. Hey, but hey, don't get excited. My mother's 90 years old with cataracts. But I remember when Bill first brought me to Jack Stanfield to talk about perhaps hiring me, and I wasn't really listening to Bill, because Bill said, you know, I need you to be a color analyst for me. I thought he said he needed me to be a color person with him. Didn't he know that that was back in the 60s? I am now black. He didn't understand that. But nevertheless, he got me involved in the business. He gave me a chance to be something other than a basketball player. He got me a chance to show the world that I had a little more talent. And I really appreciate that from you, Bill. You know, so often you have a lot of acquaintances. I had a friend, and his name was Bill Worrell. Come on up there.
I did it my way. Yes, there were times I'm sure you knew when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up.
Oh, I had so much fun with you. We had a ball, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
We set race relations back a long time when we got on the air, because this guy will say anything, as you well know. I'm up here, and I was so enthused to hear two of my closest friends, Jim Nance, and I loved him, and he went on, of course, to great things at CBS. Hannah, she didn't need anybody to teach her anything. I didn't teach Hannah Storm a thing. All I did was put her in front of a camera, and I told her dad, Mike, who was off, had the office next to me over at HSE, I said, look at her. Look how the camera loves Hannah Storm. And he said, I know it. I've been loving her whole life. But when I think of Hannah, I also think of Anita Martini, who, when I hired her, Mrs. Hobby, at KPRC was very proud because, of course, she had been the first Secretary of Health, Education, and Welfare. She was also the head of the WACs in World War II. And she was looking for women to do more in the world of sports and in news. I remember we hired, right after I went to work at Channel 2 in 1970, we hired Kay Bailey, who went on, of course, to be a great senator from the state of Texas, Kay Bailey Hutchinson. That was the first hire. Then Anita was the second. Down the list was Hannah. I had the great Lisa Miloski to work with. Patti Smith. Yeah. Patti. Patty walked into my office. I'd never, you know, she just walked in right off the street. Walked in, walked right up to my desk and said, I'm going to go to work for you. And I said, well, of course you are. I mean, what can I say about that? But she ended up not only being great and working on field with the Astros, she was a wonderful producer. We were starting to get into great things. HSE morphed into Fox, and that's when we were doing major productions and we needed a producer. So she slid right on over there and she produced for us. So I have seen her, and that's why we have. I've been to the ESPYs, and of course I know a lot of you guys on the front row have too, but this program that Patty and Janice and everybody here at the Sports Authority put on, this is one of the great presentations in the country. I can tell you that. And the athletes coming from Houston are the best. Have you ever seen a Hall of Fame like the one we have in Houston? I mean, it's incredible. Incredible. Clyde Drexler was way older than his years when he came to the University of Houston. And I remember I saw Doc in Philadelphia, and I said, we got a kid at the U of H, Julius, that's going to be just like you. And he said, I know who you're talking about. I know Clyde Drexler. He said, I keep up with my stuff. Clyde was one of the most wonderful people to cover. And of course, Roger and Sheryl all had strong mothers. Clyde had the strongest. Clyde's mother called me Worrell. She didn't call me Bill. She didn't call me Mister. She said, hey, Worrell, I heard you doing that Portland game. You were really tough on my son. I said, well, Helm, he put 41 points on us. What was I supposed to do, be nice to him? But I got in her good graces when Clyde came to Houston. And so then I could say only nice things about him, and she liked me a lot more. And Clyde, this is so well deserved. The 22s, Roger Clemens. I love Debbie better, but you're so deserving of this award. And Sheryl, I was the first Comets fan of all time. It was one of the most exciting teams. The Comets with the championships and the way you played along with Coop and Tina, it was great to see. So thank you so much, everybody, for letting me serve you in Houston. And thanks to my U of H people and fans who are here tonight, and my U of H basketball team is up there who almost went back to the Final Four this year. Thank you.
Houston Sports Hall of Famer Dan Pastorini and Houston Astros legend Jose Cruz.
Does it ever get old hearing them say Cruz when they say your name?
I thought they were booing me.
We're here tonight to present the Coach of the Year Award, and I can honestly say this is an incredible group of nominees. I'm glad I didn't have to decide the winner, but here are the nominees.
Tom Arrington, head baseball coach, San Jacinto Junior College. Dusty Baker, manager of the Houston Astros. Dana Holgerson, head football coach, the University of Houston. Kelvin Sampson, head basketball coach, the University of Houston.
Okay, and the winner is Kelvin Sampson.
You know, being here is inspiring. I don't know Justin Reed, but I heard his story tonight, and Justin, you inspired me. Bill Worrell has as much to do with me being at University of Houston as anybody during my days as an assistant with the Rockets. All those road trips in February and March, Bill would come up and sit beside me and say, "You need to come to University of Houston." Of course, I knew the history with Coach Guy V. Lewis, Elvin Hayes, Jim Nance, Clyde Drexler, The Dream, Larry Meshaw, Reed Geddes, on and on and on. So it's an honor. But like Bill said, just being here in the city of Houston, state of Texas, what we have going here in athletics is unbelievable. But it's also an honor to be with the University of Houston. Dana Holgerson, Chris Pezman, President Couture, thank you very much for the opportunity to serve your university, and we look forward to great days ahead. Go Cougs.
All right, congratulations, Coach. You folks can make a lot of noise for wearing tuxedos, and I want you to do it once again. We've got dozens of Olympians here tonight. We want to recognize those who medaled in Tokyo in 2021. Nicole Mendez is here tonight, folks. Raven Rogers, Bryce Dedman, and Simone Biles. Let's hear it, folks.
With my fellow Olympians who have all worked so hard to be here. As we all know, there is so much that goes into being an elite athlete. We've all had our challenges and have overcome so many obstacles to be able to compete on the Olympic platform. Here we have Bryce Dedman, who in Tokyo won both a gold and a bronze medal in the men's mixed 4x4. Raven Rogers, who won bronze in Tokyo in the 800. Nicole Mendez, who made history with the Mexican Softball Federation, also in Tokyo, alongside with myself, team silver medalist and individual bronze medalist. Yeah, that's you.
And one more Houston Olympian who's not on stage with us now, but will be here momentarily, as we're here to present her with the Insperity Award tonight. Her name is Tamiria Mensa Stock. She was born in Chicago, but grew up in Katy at Morton Ranch High School. Her twin sister, Takia, convinced her to try for the wrestling team after being bullied by members of her track team. She hated it at first, but grew to love it, discovering her purpose and passion. It was during this time that Tamira started to dream big and truly felt that she could be an Olympic champ, so she just kept going.
But as Simone alluded to earlier, we all have our obstacles, and Tamira's was bigger than anybody could have ever imagined. Her father tragically died in a car accident after coming to watch her compete one weekend during her first wrestling season. Tamira became angry, blaming wrestling for her father's death. This devastating situation could have taken her out, never to compete again, but it didn't.
The trials of our lives can either break us or fuel us to achieve great things. For Tamira, she went on to dominate the wrestling scene, but at the brink of international stardom, barreling through the Olympic trials, the unqualified weight class kept her from competing in the Olympics. She traveled with the team to the games that year, but only as a training partner. That experience fueled her to work even harder so that one day she'd be competing on that Olympic platform.
In 2020, she finally earned her spot on the Olympic team. In Tokyo, Tamara's dream came true as she became the first Black woman to win an Olympic gold in wrestling for the United States. And what perhaps is the most inspiring part of her story is the joy that fills her and overflows to those around her. She continues to exude this light even after such darkness. Nothing captures it more perfectly than her Olympic interview after that big win. Let's take a look.
Of course I surprised myself. It's by the grace of God I'm able to even move my feet. Like, I just leave it in his hands, and I pray that all the practice, that the hell that my freaking coach has put me through, pays off. And every single time it does, and I get better and better. And it's so weird that there is no cap to the limit that I can do. And I'm excited to see what I have next.
Last question for you. That American flag around your shoulder looks pretty good. How does that feel to represent your country like this?
Feels amazing. I love representing the U.S. I freaking love living there. I love it, and I'm so happy I get to represent you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage your Insperity Inspiration Award recipient, Tamira Mensa Stock.
I love this song. We told y'all. thank you guys so much for your support. I already have a phenomenal support team with my family, who I don't know where they're at. There they are. Yes, I did. And my husband right here. Man, through thick and thin, you know me better than anyone. And man, what we've gone through to where we are at now, you guys, it has been a roller coaster. But again, thank you for your support. And I love God, I love country, and I love all of you guys. Thank you.
All right, we welcome you back, and everybody, just time to find your seats. Hey, Houston Sports Awards always loves their relationship with McDonald's, and in a room full of celebrities, I think I found maybe the most recognizable guy here. You having a good time tonight?
The most famous redhead is in the house right here. What a fantastic night. I mean, it's 2022. The red carpet, the weather was amazing. We're in here with all the inductees. The awards are being handed out. I'm having a great time. Kevin, are you having a great time?
I'm having an awesome time.
McDonald's is having a fantastic time tonight. Hey, are you loving it? I'm loving it. Are you loving it?
You got it. All right, everybody, take their seats. We got hamburgers. Usually this is a dinner type deal, and tonight, you know, a little different. Find Steve McKinney, he'll hook you up, or I've got some right here, whoever wants. Where's Andre Ware? Where's Andre? Where's he at? Here you go. There we go. Keeping it in the Cougars' house here. Who else, right? Mayor Turner. There you go. Who else? Calvin Murphy. Get you something to eat. That man can eat, I'm telling you. All right, everybody, get your seats. We are ready to roll on with the show as we are going to start our Hall of Fame introductions.
What does it mean to be inducted into the Houston Sports Hall of Fame? It means you get to join a short list of people whose names are synonymous with Houston. Names like Olajuwon, Foreman, Bagwell, and Lewis, just to name a few. It means your name will be etched into the very heart of the city. This city we call home. This city where fans by the thousands fill stadiums and arenas. Fans who wore your name on their backs as a sign of admiration, respect, and hope. The city where fans still today stop you just to say thank you. Thank you for carrying our home on your shoulders and waving that H-Town flag proud. It means that now your name will also be synonymous with the word Houston. So, what does it take to achieve this honor? How about 15 seasons in the NBA? Being a 10-time All-Star named to the NBA's 50th and 75th anniversary teams. Winning an NBA championship for our Houston Rockets. Being a part of the 1992 Dream Team and bringing home an Olympic gold. How about being inducted not once, but twice into the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame. This honor is not for the faint of heart. You have to be good. How good? How about being the first player signed to the WNBA? Being a three-time WNBA MVP. Name one of the league's top 15 players of all time. And you want to talk synonymous? How about not just a franchise, but the face of an entire league? How about not one, not two, but three Olympic golds? One NCAA championship and making our hometown proud with four WNBA championships. Elected to the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame and inducted into the Women's Hall of Fame. Oh yeah, and the first female ever to have a Nike shoe named after. That's a taste of what it takes. But sit down and buckle up, because we're not done. It takes toughness. How tough? How about 24 seasons in Major League Baseball, playing for four different teams, being one of the most dominant pitchers in the league's history. 354 wins, 4,672 strikeouts. Did you hear what I just said? 4,672 strikeouts, third most of all time. An 11-time All-Star, two-time World Series champion, winner of seven, that's right, seven Cy Young Awards. That's more than any other pitcher in history. Talk about synonymous. When your name is the Rocket, there's only one city you can call home. Space City, baby. Ladies and gentlemen, get up and make some noise as we get ready to honor your newest Houston Sports Hall of Fame inductees, Clyde the Glide Drexler, Sheryl Swoopes, and Roger the Rocket Clemens.
Woo! Man, I am so fired up. Bon V, what a fabulous job voicing that and getting us all hyped as we are going to honor three H-Town legends tonight, Roger Clemens, Clyde the Glide Drexler, and Sheryl Swoopes. Cannot wait. All right, so let's get this party started, shall we? As I mentioned earlier, I was the first play-by-play voice of the WNBA. Now, that was a daunting task. I was completely terrified, especially given that I had a newborn baby at the time. But here's the key. So did Sheryl Swoopes. Yes, she did. From the moment I met her and I saw the determination of that mama, and then I watched her come back, lead her team to championships, she inspired me so much with her strength and her will as she embarked on her singular career, all the while adjusting to life as a new mom. And then years later, it was a privilege for me to direct a film about Sheryl and her journey, and I am saying even LeBron tweeted about it, okay? We're flexing tonight. Let's take a look at what happened when Sheryl got the news that she was being inducted into the Houston Sports Hall of Fame.
At the Houston Sports Hall of Fame, and that's what we're here for today, because you're being inducted into the class of 2022.
Hi, everybody. It's a tremendous pleasure for me to be here to help induct Sheryl Swoopes into the Houston Sports Hall of Fame, an honor she so richly deserves. Sheryl has broken ground throughout her incredible career. And her many firsts include being the first player 25 years ago to sign a contract to play in the WNBA. A very lucky day for all of us connected at that time with the league. Some of my most vivid memories in basketball have been watching Sheryl dazzle on the court, first at Texas Tech, then when she was on the Olympic team, and then when she was part of that incredible and beloved Houston Comets dynasty. Sheryl, you helped put the Comets and the WNBA on the map, and you proved beyond a doubt what women in basketball could do, both as a player and as a mom. We all owe you a huge debt of gratitude. You're a Hall of Famer through and through, and I want to send my congratulations and my love to you on this very special occasion. You made a difference, and you still got game. When you dream big, when you work hard, when you don't give up, no matter how far life pushes you down, no matter how much you hurt, you can always bounce back. I think at a very young age, I knew that God had blessed me with a talent that not a lot of people had. And it was up to me to decide what I was going to do with that talent. I always told myself that basketball would be my ticket to college and not only change my life, but my mom's life.
Sheryl Swoopes defied the odds. Born in Brownfield, Texas, she was raised by a single mom along with her three brothers. They didn't have much, but she had a vision and determination to succeed. That vision ultimately brought her to Texas Tech.
When she played for Texas Tech, everybody's like, oh man, Sheryl Swoopes about to come on. We gotta watch her.
Where she led the Red Raiders to the NCAA National Championship. After college, she went on to win Olympic gold in 1996, which would be her first of three. After being signed to the WNBA, she was forced to sit out the first 19 games of the inaugural season, being pregnant with her son, Jordan. She made her debut just 6 weeks after his birth and went on to win the title that year in 1997, the first of four consecutive world championships with the Houston Comets. In 2008, she signed with the Storm, bringing leadership to the team. It was there she recorded both her 600th career steal and 200th career block against her former team, the Houston Comets, becoming the first WNBA player to hit that milestone. In 2016, Sheryl Denise Swoopes was inducted into the Naismith Basketball Hall of Fame. In 2017, she was also inducted into the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame.
Sheryl is such a champion, such an elite player, and somebody I looked up to greatly.
There were moments throughout her career where Sheryl was unsure if she could handle the pressure of being who she had become. But throughout it all, she had all the support she needed to make it through. And she made us all proud, an inspiration to people everywhere. All because she never gave up. And never give up. Don't ever give
up. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Grammy Award winning gospel singer Yolanda Adams.
Tenacity, amazing artistry. That's what I see when I see my sister and my friend, Sheryl Swoopes. And with a name like Swoopes, you better be able to. Whoo. She has been such a wonderful addition to the Houston family and to all of our families, especially my family. We are so excited at this moment and at this time to bring this phenomenal woman who is family, who is, wow, what else can we say? She's just the best, okay? Three times three. Okay, I have to ask Clyde this. So we understand triple doubles, but what about triple triples? Okay, just kidding. We want to welcome Miss Sheryl Swoopes into the Houston Sports Hall of Fame. Please come up. Yes.
Jackets are designed and created by Not Standard.
looking good in the jacket. I love it. Congratulations. Listen, guess what? Because a Hall of Famer like you has to have some bling. I mean, we have to have some jewels to go with that, like a beautiful Hall of Fame ring. So if you will, turn to the screen and see what else we get to go with that jacket.
Okay.
Cheryl's Hall of Fame ring is done in 18 karat gold and sterling silver. There's over 3 carats of gemstones in the ring. The background is tight knit, investment grade white pave, and the 22 is made out of 22 interlocking sapphires in the middle.
Okay, that'll do, right? So here she is, Hall of Famer, Sheryl Swoopes. The mic is yours. Go right up, sure, we'll hold it for you. We'll take that.
Okay, y'all sit down. Hey! Gosh, you guys, the lights are bright. I'm gonna talk fast because I was told I only have 3 minutes. I was also told not to bring my phone up, but y'all, I'm 51. I can't remember some things. Clyde, can you relate? Roger, can you relate? I don't know, I'm just asking. Listen, oh my gosh. I'm gonna try to get through this without getting too emotional. And I was good until I saw my mom's picture with the flowers sitting in this seat over here. Man, my mom is the reason why I'm here today. So I truly miss her. So I have my phone because there's so much I want to say and so many people that I have to thank, and I don't want to forget anybody. I want to just start off by saying Yolanda Adams. I love me some Yolanda Adams. This is not about you. I love Yolanda Adams, Joseph. Listen, sis, I just want to say to you, you got me through so much as a basketball player. Just your music, everything about it, everything you represent, everything you stand for, and especially those times when Coach Chancellor, who's here somewhere, was getting on me, even though people didn't think he did. All I had to do was go turn on some Yolanda Adams, and I said, Jesus, somebody help me. But I am so grateful and so thankful that you accepted, and for you to be here tonight for me means more to me than you would ever know. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you, and I love you. All right, I'm gonna get through this really quick. You guys, God is so good. And he continues to show me favor every single day. What an incredible night to be here, to be in the presence of so many incredible, beautiful, talented people. But before I get into what this really means to me, there are definitely a few people that I have to acknowledge and thank for playing such a huge part in my life, whether that was on the court or off the court. And I'm gonna start with my crew in this section up here. And I said I wasn't gonna call people out by name because y'all know when you forget somebody right after this, it's gonna be like, well, you ain't say nothing about me. Well, if I forget you, charge it to my head and not my heart. Lyle and Trish Milstead. I just wanna say thank you. Thank you for being there, for me, for Jordan. Ooh, I'm getting the music. Y'all know what that means. Let me go fast. Just thank you. I love you guys. Ray Pond, my Texas Tech crew who is here. You guys, I was rocking red and black. I bleed red and black. Texas Tech, Houston Comets. It's such an incredible honor. God has blessed me beyond measure. I wouldn't be here without my family. My brothers who are here, I love you guys. Thank you for the love, the support.
And that little boy that you guys saw on this screen, he is now a grown man, 24. Stand up, he's in the front row with me. And so when you guys saw me carrying him on my back and my neck, now it's time for him to carry me on his. Truly, from the bottom of my heart, Houston Sports Authority, thank you for this award. Thank you for this honor. It means more to me than you would ever know. I am a Houstonian. I love you guys. Thank you, and everybody have a blessed night.
I remember one of my first jobs ever was working at McDonald's. And the reason why I took the job, this is a little secret, but I've always loved their fries. So every time I would go to work, I would kind of sneak in. I would put tons of salt on them, first of all, and I would sneak and eat fries while I was at work. And I had to sneak because that wasn't something we were supposed to do. But I've always loved the fries, I still love the fries, and that is my fondest McDonald's memory.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage 1989 Heisman Trophy winner, Andre Ware, Pro Football Hall of Famer, Warren Moon, and College Football Hall of Famer, Vince Young.
It is hard to believe that we've been doing this for 3 years, and I honestly can say that I've never been a part of anything that was more rewarding than what we do on this night. We are about to introduce four new scholarship recipients to all of you. Like us, they participated in sports and were raised by single moms.
And you know, Dre, what's really cool is the three of us, we've kind of formed this brotherhood together through this whole process, yeah. And now we've got these students who have come together, and they're almost like family to us. Well, now we have seven recipients that are part of our program and part of our family, and we're so much looking forward to this next four that we're going to present tonight. So really proud of all of them. They're all doing very great in school right now, and you guys will get to meet them here in a minute.
Yeah, the hardest part for us, it's always narrowing it down to just four. It's always hard. We had a lot of great applicants, but we are very proud to introduce to you guys our year's class.
Neil, who will be attending the University of Oklahoma, Saviana attending Trinity College in Hartford, Connecticut, Cohen going to Texas Tech right down the road, and Katrina, who will be going to the University of Penn. Come on up, congratulations.
You can see the love that we have for them, and each year it just gets better and better. Congratulations, we're so proud of you guys. We're also proud and super proud, because we wouldn't be here tonight without our title sponsor and the guys that really take care of us, partnering with TDECU. And with that, I'd like to bring up the president CEO of TDECU, Mr. Isaac Johnson, who would like to present a check and give each one of you an additional $1,000 towards your education.
Big money.
Awesome. Thank you, Josh. Thank you, Isaac. Thank you to TDECU. Thank you for everyone here who helped support the Brothers in Arms. We hope to see you guys at our golf tournament. If you like getting your butt whooped, come holler at me, please. I will take your money. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
What you want, what you gonna do? When you should be strong, don't come for
How you doing, Clyde?
Yes, sir. Clyde, you have been selected to be the class of 2022 for the Houston Sports Hall of Fame.
I am honored.
Clyde the Glide, you're up. Clyde Drexler, of course, was named one of the NBA's 75 greatest players of all time. And, oh yeah. We have another guy who happens to be on that list here to present Clyde with his well-deserved award. In fact, he's the guy who was the face of two leagues, the ABA and the NBA, who also presented Clyde at the Naismith Basketball Hall of Fame back in 2004. He's back again to do the honors, a guy that I've known since I was a little girl, and so privileged to introduce him tonight, the one, the only, Dr. J.
Good evening. She mentioned the ABA, and I can hug her, because she was about 12 years old when her father was the commissioner of the ABA, and I played in the ABA. So that's when we met. We go back that far. What a wonderful evening, you know. Yeah. This is truly special. Every city should claim their talent the way that Houston claims their talent. As a matter of fact, I feel like a Houstonian. I do. I do. I came in at the airport. Everybody was nice and friendly. I went to the hotel. Everybody was nice and friendly. I went to get some snacks. I went around the corner to the little food shop over there on Main. Everybody was nice and friendly. I came here tonight. Everybody was nice and friendly. Why is everybody being so friendly to me? I'm not that nice a guy. If you get within the black lines, I will dunk on you. Almost as good as the person who I'm presenting. And I say almost, because he does something that I never did and Michael Jordan never did. Because I would go up like this. Michael would go up like this, and Clyde used to put his heels upon his booty and go up like this. That was pretty special. You own that. So why am I here? I was asked once to come and be at a dinner reception, kind of hors d'oeuvres reception. When Clyde Drexler is being honored, and at the time when I was asked, he was commissioner of the Big Three, and I coach in the Big Three. So those last 5 years have been very delightful spending time together. But before that, you know, we've been to China together a few times. I've been in the company of his four children. He's been in the company of my four sons and three daughters. And we truly call one another friends. And every now and then, probably once every other week, sometimes three times a month, the phone will ring, and I'll pick it up, and he'll say, 6-6. And I'll say, yes, it's 6-6, because we both kind of topped out at 6-6, and that's just our little thing between us. He's 6-6, I'm 6-6, but while we're on numbers, something happened 2 months ago that will never happen again. First of all, I won't be 72 again. But on 2022, that was my birthday. February 22nd, 2022. And now we're here with the wonderful honorees who all wore 22, Sheryl, Mr. Clemens, and Mr. Drexler. My honor to just salute you at this particular time, and especially you, Clyde, because we've done so much together. And you know, I'm the big brother, you're the little brother, but you know, we've established ourselves in a way that I think it started with our moms, because my mom said, everywhere you go, you're always representing this family. Don't you forget that, boy. And I know he had a similar message. I know he had a similar message. And he has always represented the family in such a, you know, he's never really loud and boisterous, but he's always heard because he's fact-based. And I think when he and Tanya got together, decided to seal the deal, you know, it was proud of me to be there at the wedding. And he had somebody else who, mom can never be replaced, but he had another lady in his life who he always represents. So brother, come on up and represent the family, the four kids, mom, your mother, your city, because Houston is your city. Always has been, and always
Drexler. Smooth, high flying, effortless, spectacular. A Houston legend on the court, playing for legendary teams Sterling, Bar Slammer Gemma, the Dream Team, the Blazers, and the Houston Rockets. Someone so good, he had his number retired at both the college and professional level. The iconic number 22, two consecutive Final Four appearances. Named as one of the 50 greatest players in NBA history. Making it to three NBA finals and ultimately returning home to reunite with Hakeem Olajuwon. Empowering the Rockets with a 22, that's right. 22-game playoff run to ultimately win the 1995 NBA championship. He was an Olympic gold medalist on the 1992 U.S. Olympic team. He's one of the top 10 all-time leading scorers for the Houston Rockets. Inducted two times into the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame. Five-time All-NBA team. 10-time All-Star. The only in NBA history to top 20,000 points, 6,000 rebounds, 6,000 assists, and 2,000 steals. 15 professional seasons of smooth operating that took him to the top.
Do the honors. So give it up, Houston Rocket, three-time NBA champ. Before Clyde the Glide, here we go. This man has a few words.
All right, all right.
Sorry I had to do that.
I think I got my mic right here. I think I got one right here.
You're good.
I'm good.
This is super smooth. All right, here we go.
First Mario and foremost, LA. Want to shout out to my girl Hannah Storm for covering us back in the championship days. And I got to follow a legend, my hometown legend, Dr. J. I mean, how do I follow that? Very excited, man, for this honor. Brother, friend, teammate, just a wonderful individual. Clyde, I didn't know your middle name was Austin. Clyde Austin Drexler. I just found that out doing some research on you. But just a tremendous, you saw all the accolades.
top 50, top 75. But what's most disturbing was that 1983 draft, Clyde. All the list of them bums that was picked before you. And out of that first round, Clyde is the only one to be top 50 and top 75. Yes, and a Hall of Famer. But the worst part about it, Houston had two picks in that draft. But I ain't gonna throw my guy, I know my boy Rodney McCray's in the building. He was the third pick. Sampson was the number one pick. But the number 14th pick in the draft, you saw what it turned out to be. One of the greatest to ever lace him up. So let's give him up for that. I played with Clyde 5 years, went to Portland. When I left Golden State, went to Portland, met Clyde there. But that summer, I got traded to the Rockets. I'm like, man, Akeem Olajuwon, I ran out of Portland so quick. But of course, who was following me the following year? Number 22, Clyde Drexler. Quick story, when we traded for Clyde, none of us guards were happy because we knew our playing time was going to get cut short. So a lot of guys were against Clyde, but Clyde being cool and calm like he always is, he let his play do the talking. And when we played Utah in that first round of the finals, when our backs against the wall in the biggest game of our season, this man showed up big time and let everybody know why he won the top 50 greatest, had 41 points, and went on and we won the first championship for Clyde. Clyde doesn't get enough credit, in my opinion, taking the Blazers to the finals twice in a Bird, Magic, Jordan, Isaiah Thomas era, where all those guys were at their peak. Clyde took that Blazer team to two finals. I just want to tell Clyde, he went from Rip City to Clutch City, all right? He went from Rip City to Clutch City. And I want to welcome my man, my brother, one of the greatest to ever do it. I can say he's my friend, to the Houston Sports Hall of Fame, the great Clyde Drexler. My man. Put this jacket on you, Clyde.
The Hall of Fame jackets are designed and created by Not Standard.
There you go. That's a fit. And you know, as Clyde knows, it don't mean a thing if you ain't got that ring. So let's take a look at your Hall of Fame bling.
Clyde's Hall of Fame ring is done in 18 karat gold and sterling silver. The background is made out of tight-knit pave. It's over 116 stones total. The 22 on top is done with Burmese rubies, they interlocking together to give the total all spectacular effect.
Ooh, nice. Okay. You finally get to talk. How about that?
Thank you, Hannah. You know it's a big event when Hannah comes to town, right? Hannah's Houston, you make Houston proud. We've been watching you and your success through the years. You make all of us feel good. For your success. You represent us very well. Now, I am delighted to be here today. This is a wonderful event. I want to thank the Houston Sports Authority, the Houston Hall of Fame, for putting on a great party. That's what this is, Julius. This is the party. As you said, other cities would be well served to put on an event such as this, right? This is phenomenal. I don't know how y'all got Julius to come back over here. But I appreciate it. Julius has been a big brother. You know, he's been a lifelong friend. I've learned so many lessons just talking to him. He's a wealth of knowledge. He was willing to share that. I think I first met Julius, I was 17 years old. Big Moses Malone brought me in the locker room and said, "Hey, Doc, it's going to be the next Doc, this little Doc." Julius looked at me. You know, he's the greatest player in the game, for sure, right? Moses is comparing me to him. I'm 17 years old, and I'm thinking, Moses, are you nuts? What is wrong with you? But Julius was gracious as ever. He says, "Hey, little man, welcome. I'll be watching you. Here's my number. If you need anything, give me a buzz." Of course, I'm 17, and I'm thinking, I'm never calling him. That's Julius Irving. Who in their right mind would call him? I'm not bothering him. But so gracious every time, and we became like brothers. I think the first time we really bonded, you had your wife's, you celebrated an anniversary in Philly, and he invited me to come. And we hung out, and we've been great friends, brothers, ever since. So, Julius, thank you. I love you. One of the greatest to ever do it, the doctor. Mario Ellie, the junkyard dog. Come on, you gotta love it. We gotta get Mario on this podium. He is a Houston icon. You know, hit some of the biggest shots in the history of the Rockets franchise, right? The JYD. My brother. Yeah, I like Mario, but I think I might like Gina better. I don't know. Well, thank you again, Mario. And now, I want to say my family is here. I don't want to be remiss. My lovely wife, thank you. Tanya, stand up. My mother, who Bill Worrell says, she tells it like it is. She is a no-nonsense mother, but the most supportive, the most loving mother you could ever ask for. Great guidance for many, many years. My son, Adam, is here. My daughter, Erica, her brother, Manny. And all my family, I have my brother James, my sister Denise, and my other sister Virginia. And those two are known in the Houston city for pickleball. They're some of the best pickleballers in the city. So everywhere they go, people see that last name and they go, hey, Clyde, I played against your sisters and man, they just beat everybody. I go, yeah, they're pretty good. But they've been sneaking up on people for years. But thank you all for being here. Let me tell you something. I grew up in Houston. I'm Houston proud. But one of the things that make this city great is the diversity of Houston. We come from all walks of life, and everybody gets along so well. Yes. I love it. And so people always say, why do you stay in Houston, Clyde, everywhere you go? Because that's home. Home is where the heart is, right? Houston's a fabulous city. We're 2 hours from everywhere. You get value for your money. No state taxes. Come on. We got great weather. We got beautiful people. And we got sunshine. So you gotta love it, right? So before I get off of here, I wanna say, Bill, congratulations. Congratulations to the Rocket. Congratulations to Sheryl. You guys are some of the best to ever do it. And I'm delighted to share this stage with you tonight.
Chelsea and Jonathan Miles, they are owner-operators of McDonald's, a couple of McDonald's here in the Houston area. They got a special presentation to make. I know, guys, that Brothers in Arms presentation really spoke to you guys. Chelsea, I'm going to start with you.
Yes, it really spoke to us. And on behalf of McDonald's owner-operators across Houston, we wanted to make a contribution to the Brothers in Arms because it touched us so much. So we're going to contribute an extra $5,000 on behalf of McDonald's owner-operators in Houston, Texas.
Getting a standing ovation from a couple of Hall of Famers over here. You guys have two stores, one right by University of Houston, one on campus, right?
Yes, we have the McDonald's right on Elgin Street. So if y'all want some fresh fries, come visit us.
All right, I have a feeling there's going to be a couple people over here that are going to want to shake you guys' hands. Thank you very much. All right, time now for our Athlete of the Year. We welcome to the stage Paulo Nagamura of the Houston Dynamo and James Clarkson, the head coach of the Houston Dash, for our Athlete of the Year.
Many great athletes in every sport, year in, year out. Tonight we have nominees from the Astros. The Astros and the Astros.
Well, who can blame them? They had a fantastic run to the World Series. But we do also have the most decorated US Olympic gymnast of all time. Here are the nominees for Athlete of the Year.
Simone Biles, United States Olympian. Carlos Correa, Houston Astros. Yuli Gurriel, the Houston Astros. Kyle Tucker, the Houston Astros.
And the winner is... Carlos Correa.
Hi guys, Carlos Correa here. Thank you so much for this prestigious award. First, I would like to congratulate the Hall of Famers being inducted tonight. Roger Clemens, Clyde Drexler, and Sheryl Swoopes. And my fellow nominees, Simone Biles, my brother Julie Gurriel, and Kyle Tucker. I would also like to express my gratitude to the Houston Sports Award, the Houston Sports Authority, and the Insperity for this prestigious award and naming me Athlete of the Year. Thank you guys so much. It is a privilege not only for me, but also for my family and my home country of Puerto Rico and everyone involved on my development as an athlete, because without you, none of this will ever be possible. Finally, I would also like to take this opportunity to say thank you to the city of Houston from the bottom of my heart and their amazing fans who have supported me since day one on my professional career in Houston. Thank you guys so much. I will always love you.
Accepting the award on behalf of Carlos, his father, Carlos A. Correa.
For Roger Clemens, it is now his 10th and final opportunity.
On the ballot for another 5 years to 15 years like before, I think they'd get
it. You can't write the history of the sport without it. I don't think you should sanitize your museum.
When you talk about 7 Cy Young Awards, it's undeniable. And plus, he's a champion, so we got to give credit where credit is due.
Maybe it's a fundamental disagreement.
Of what the Hall of Fame
of what the Hall of Fame should be.
All the money that they generated. No. All the money. Exactly. So we took from them, and then we want to act like they didn't exist. But the money exists. But the popularity exists. Put them in.
The Houston Sports Awards stands by our decision to induct Roger Clemens into the 2022 Houston Sports Hall of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Kobe and Corey Clemens.
Hey, give it up for Holly Forbes. Outstanding, huh? And before we get started, I just got to say this is a proud moment for me, Corey, and the two brothers that couldn't be here. There's no one more deserving than you, Pops. For everything you did on the field, obviously, and then everything off the field that you've done for this great city, state, and all the things you do. We love you, Pops. Couldn't be more proud. All right, here we go. All right, you guys might know him as the Rocket.
Or you may know him as Poppy Rocket.
Or some of you may know him as DJ, DJ, no request, quest, quest.
Well, he's our dad, one of the greatest of all time.
The next megastar who is here to introduce our dad is also the greatest to ever do it in his line of work. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome
Big Dog Daddy.
Welcome to the hillbilly portion of this show. I don't know how the hell I got talked into this, but me and Rock go way back, golf pals, Debbie and my wife Tricia, and me and Roger met years ago, and we've watched our kids grow up together, these boys and their other two, and they've watched mine, and become a great family. I had about 7 or 8 pages they gave me to tell you how great Roger is, but I couldn't read his writing. So I'm just going to wing it. Went to the Hall of Fame in Cooperstown years ago. I was playing in New York and I had the night off. I wanted to see Cooperstown. I'm a huge baseball fan. And I went up there and I said to the curator of the museum, he said, come by and we'll take you around, let you see everything. I said, I'm going to see strikeouts first. So I went to the strikeout and there was my boy, 20 strikeouts twice. Now there's only 27 in a game. So he did it twice, and he did it in the American League with great designated hitters instead of pitchers like they were getting off in the NL. So there was one guy that was up there at 21, and I never heard of him before, and I said, who's the knucklehead with 21? And they told me, and I said, why is he up there? And they said, well, he did that in 16 innings. And I said, damn, my boy did it in 9. Damn. Can't have him up there. So we got down to the... they call it the vault. And we got down in the vault, and they made me put some gloves on. And they said, what do you want to do? I said, I want to hold Babe Ruth's bat. So I held Babe Ruth's bat, took my picture. I want to hold Willie Mays' glove that he made that great catch in center field. So I held that and posed that picture. I said, what do y'all got of Rogers down here? They said, we got his jock strap. I said, well, I want to hold it. Because I knew someday somebody was going to ask me, hanging out with him, if I ever played baseball. And I said, I played Little League. And I pitched. And they said, how good were you? And I said, I was just like Roger Clemens. And they said, you couldn't carry Roger's jock strap. Roger, I carried your jock, buddy. Carried it all over the Hall of Fame. I want y'all to join and welcome Roger Clemens. Houston Sports Hall of Fame. My father.
The Hall of Fame jackets are designed and created by Not Standard.
You got the boys helping you out here. All right, guys. That's a good fit. That looks good, huh? A little Hall of Famer. Hey, you know what? We got a ring for you, too. We're not leaving you out. Let's take a look. All right.
Roger's Hall of Fame ring is set in 18-karat yellow gold and sterling silver. There's over 116 gemstones that make up this masterpiece. The background is tight-knit pave. The 22 is done with rare mandarin garnets to make this one-of-a-kind spectacular ring.
Hey.
Dad, it's your son here. I'm just here to congratulate you on the Houston Sports Hall of Fame. That's awesome. I'm so proud of you. I wish I could be there for the awards ceremony, but more importantly, you're a Hall of Fame dad. I love you.
Dad, it's Casey. Just wanted to congratulate you on the Houston Sports Hall of Fame. As you know, I'm out here in New York. Love you. Wish I was there to celebrate with you. Congratulations. You are very deserving. You're the best.
Man, where do I start? I guess I, Sheryl and Clyde, congrats. What an honor it is for me as a 22 double deuce to be honored 2-2 with you guys. I guess with Patty, I guess I'm glad we didn't wear number 55. We'd had to wait a while maybe, I don't know. Yeah, I'm glad we wore 22. Bill, I know about strong mothers, and I know about strong mother-in-laws, just so everybody in this building knows. My mom, who passed, she was, let's see, lingo, if you're going to go hillbilly on me, Tobe. My mom was tougher than a $2 steak, and and in this building, my nana, my mother-in-law, who's back there, Nana, I love you. Yeah, She's, Nana's stronger than a garlic milkshake. You ever had a garlic milkshake? She's stronger than that. I'll tell you that right now. So, a lot of friends and family in here. Like I said, this is home for me. Deb and I still live 8 miles from our high school. So to have the opportunity to come out of retirement and come home and pitch for the Houston Astros was a thrill for me. Yeah. Unbelievable teammates, professional teammates that made me look good out there. They paid great attention to detail. And that's what I expected when I was on the mound, to be ready to go and well-versed on who we're going to be facing, who we're going to be trying to get out. Special to me and my family and friends here, you saw two of my older boys behind me, my other two there on the screen. I love them boys to death, the coolest thing ever. The way they carry themselves, the way they treated me as a dad when I came home from work. Again, Nana's here. Once my mom passed away, my grandmother, my pops passed away when I was 9. I was raised by two strong-willed women, my mother and my grandmother. Make no mistake about it. After that, I had a wonderful base. I have three sisters. One of my sisters here with me tonight, Boo, I love you. She's back there. My other sisters are watching on, I'm sure. Two brothers. Again, just great, great family, great support. And then, of course, I was very lucky once I got to University of Texas. I met this girl. They said, "You got a unicorn?" I married a unicorn down here. Her name's Deborah Lynn, right there in the front row. I captured a unicorn. But anyway, I love y'all. Thanks for having us here. Tobe, thanks so much. Big Dog Daddy in the house. Thanks so much for being here doing this for me, buddy. And what a great honor, and thank y'all very much.
In the house, right? We thought we'd sing a little song. I don't know. Ain't as good as I once was. That doesn't seem appropriate. Whiskey girl, probably not.
She was 5'2", about 95 pounds. She was round in the places she was supposed to be round. Now, you can take the waitress or the blonde over there, but stand back, Tobe. That's the size I wear.
I love it. All right, so let's do a little Red Solo Cup then, right? Should we? Come on out. Hey, both y'all on the mic, all the Hall of Famers, yes, come on out. Y'all all have Red Solo Cups under your seats. Grab your Red Solo Cups, y'all come up on stage.
Come on, J-Dub. Now Red Solo Cup is the best receptacle for barbecues, tailgates, fairs, the festivals, and you, sir, do not have a pair of testicles if you prefer drinking from glass. Hey, Red Solo Cup. Cheap and disposable, 14 years. They are decomposable, not like my home. They are not proposable. Freddie Mac kiss my ass. Woo! Red Solo Cup, I'll fill you up. Let's have a party. Let's have a party. I brought my Red Solo Cup. Red Solo, I'll fill you up. Proceed to party. Stack, and I really hate how you're easy to crack. And when beer runs down in front of my back, well, that, my friend, is quite yucky. But I have to admit that the ladies get smitten in mind how sharply my first name is written on you with a sharpie. When I get to hitting on them, to help.